Bridgerton talks about Anthony and his search for a fertile domesticated half-brain to call a wife. You can say the Viscount chopped off his face mullet and a chunk of his thinking lump along with it. After getting dumped last year, he not only gave up on love, but he gave up on seeing women as nothing more than childbearing, brassy noise. Perfect time for him to announce his wedding intentions, and he figured out just the right formula. He's this year's most eligible bachelor. You bet your rear end is gonna act on it. Welcome to the 1800s, The Bachelor, where getting the girl is equivalent to her passing a series of demeaning interviews. The girls are begging for his attention, but he seems to have met a worthy opponent already. While promenading away from the thirsty gals, his chivalrous senses started tickling. A horse-riding belle can only be in distress after all, and he proclaims himself as the hero. He couldn't be an X-Man, might as well be an Avenger. Too bad this damsel needs no saving. And she's galloping to the beat of his heart.
Aww.
If only she wasn't a broke 26-year-old spinster. After some intense, fiery banter, she bids him farewell, and he wonders. If she can ride a horse like that, what else could she possibly ride? Flash forward a few days later, as their fates intertwine at yet another ball. One look at Anthony and she was like, that's one extra whipped buttercream right there. Staring is scaring, and so is low-key stalking. So she follows him outside and eavesdrops on his locker room chit-chat, where he describes his dream girl. Quiet, with sufficient wit, and who sticks her pinky out while sipping tea. How hard can that be in good old Regency London? Hard AF, according to his mother.
You will end up alone. With such expectations.
But according to Kate, he shall shove his long list of qualifiers in his pretty bum-bum. She gives him a mouthful and kicks him to the curb.
Your character is as deficient as your horsemanship. I shall bid you good night.
Not to be a party pooper, but Lady Dignity here has her own devious schemes on the side. She's a normie in the land of the extras, and her money is running low. The quickest way to earn a fat regency back is if her sister Edwina marries a noble Englishman. Edwina's mother eloped with an Indian brokey back in the day, aka Kate's father, and that left her parents salty and pressed. And now they want the new gent to hang with the upper crust to earn a slice of their pie. Lucky for them, the queen seems to be on their side. Bridgerton's certified matchmaker convinced Queen Charlotte to pick Edwina as the season's diamond. That title sure caught Anthony's attention, because he's a little wuss and capable of formulating an opinion on his own. Edwina checks all his boxes, with the added bonus of family tragedy.
Is your father in attendance? I should like to speak with him.
Sadly, my father died years ago.
Oh. I'm so sorry. As did mine.
If he can't have Kate, he'll have the closest thing to her gene pool, I guess. To be continued.